I'm Mickey here recording for WIMPS.TV at the LGBT Russia Solidarity Protest organised by the Rainbow Project.
Well, I think it's to draw attention to the plight of LGBT people in Russia. Over the last 18 months, we've seen an increase in totalitarianism, oppression against LGBT populations, and a crackdown on free speech. So it's to draw attention to that today at the opening of the Winter Olympics in Sochi in 2014.
I came down because today is the opening night of the Olympics, the Winter Olympics in Sochi in Russia. And obviously we know of all the new laws that Vladimir Putin, who's the president there, has brought in. And we're just protesting in solidarity, really. We don't think this protest is going to change anything, but we're here to show solidarity for our brothers and sisters who are LGBTQ in Russia, who are suffering at the hand of these new homo promo laws.
I came out today to show my support for my brothers and sisters in the LGBTQ community throughout the world, especially in Russia, where people are hunted down like dogs. What's the need for that? We're in 2014. Not in 1900s. It's about time that the world realised that there is gays, lesbians, transgenders, queers, whatever they want to call us out there. And we're not going to be put back into the 60s where we had to hide and not come out.
I'm here tonight to show solidarity for the people that are being persecuted in Russia, and also to sort of say that we are being mistreated by our own government and we don't have full equality here. And Russia's not the worst country in the world, there's still worse going on, so I think it's important that everyone is aware of what is going on in the world here in Sub-Saharan Africa and everywhere else.
That's important to me because I'm gay, you know, I identify as gay, and you know, similar things are happening here, you know, we all know about Edwin Poots and his latest sort of escapades, you know, he's got the blood bank going. We won the adoption case, thank God, but you know, there's still loads going on. Women still don't have fertility rights here. So I'm here because it's personal to me. You know, when somebody's rights are infringed anywhere, it's the same. It affects us all.
In Russia, this type of protest would be illegal under the new gay propaganda laws, where it makes it illegal to say being gay is good or is as good as being straight, or to agitate for gay equality. So this very protest in Russia would be illegal, and we could potentially face criminal conviction because of it. So it's about standing for those who can't, and it's important that when we recognise our own advances in terms of our struggle for equality, we've got to think about those who can't stand and protest.
I feel today we have got our message across. We've had support from passers-by, driving by, companies that shouldn't really be getting involved and beeping, they've been beeping. And it's good to let the people out there know that we won't stand for this. It doesn't matter whether you're in Belfast, whether you're in Vancouver, or whether you're in Russia.
Aye, aye, aye. Aye, aye, aye. Aye, aye, aye.